Today we study some string methods and built-in functions. So today also continue like that. So here the first string method and built-in functions are isalnum, which means that is alphanumeric. So check that the string contains alphanumeric characters. So it returns true if the character of a given strings are either alphabets or numeric. So it is alphanumeric means alphabets and numeric. So if white space or special symbol are the part of the given string or the string is empty, it returns false. So here one example is there, string 1 is equal to hello world. So look at that, there is no white symbol and there is no special symbol. So here then we need to check str1 dot is alphanumeric. So it returns true because it contains only alphabets. So next one is str1 is equal to hello world 2. So it contains an alphabet and a number. So then check that str1 dot is alphanumeric, then it also returns true. So next one is string 1 is equal to hello world, then there is two special symbols are there. Then we need to check str1 dot is alphanumeric, then it returns false because it contains special symbols. So which means that it returns true if the character of a given strings are either alphabet or numeric. If white space or special symbol are part of a given string, it returns false. So this is the use of isalnum, means is alphanumeric. So next method is isLower. So it returns true if the string is non-empty and has all lowercase alphabets or has at least one character as a lower alphabet and the rest of the non-alphabets are characters. So here look at that an example, str1 is equal to hello world. Then one last one symbols are the last one special symbol is there. Then check that str1 dot is lower, then it returns true because it contains small case letter only. Then str1 is equal to hello 1 2 3 4, it is also returns true because it contains small letters. Then look at that str1 is equal to hello, then white space, then question mark. So it is also str1 is 1 dot is lower, it also returns true because it contains small letters. So then look at that str1 is equal to 1 2 3 4. So 1 2 3 4 means it is a number. So here str1 dot is lower, so it returns false because it not contain any small letter. So next one is str1 is equal to hello, then space world, then one special symbol is there. So then str1 dot is lower, it returns false. Why it is returns false means look at that it has at least one character as a lowercase alphabet and rest are non-alphabet, then only it returns true. Here it contains small letter but it contains white space and all other letters means it contains white space and special symbol, so that's why it returns false. So this is the use of is lower. Then is upper is there opposite to is lower. So is upper means it returns true if the string is non-empty and has all uppercase alphabets or has at least one character as uppercase character and the rest are non-alphabets characters. So first one is string 1 is equal to hello world, so it returns true. Then string one is hello 1 2 3 4, it also returns true. Then string 1 is equal to hello, then space run 2 question mark, this also returns true. Then look at that next 1 2 3 4, then str1 dot is upper, it returns false because it is not containing any uppercase character. Then look at that str1 is equal to hello, then space world, then there is one special character, so it is also returns false because the rest of the character is not a alphabet characters. Here look at that, this is the example of is upper and is lower, then is alphanumeric. These are the main three string built-in functions in Python.